I heard you in the garden, but I was afraid because I was naked, so I hid myself. Then he asked, who told you that you were naked? You have eaten then from the tree of which I had forbidden you to eat. The man replied, the woman whom you put here with me, she gave me fruit from the tree, and so I ate it. The Lord God then asked the woman, why did you do such a thing? The woman answered, the serpent tricked me into it, so I ate it. Then the Lord God said to the serpent, because you have done this, you shall be banned from all the animals and from all the wild creatures. On your belly shall you crawl, and dirt shall you eat all the days of your life. I will put enmity between you and the woman, and between your offspring and hers. He will strike at your head while you strike at his heel. The man called his wife Eve, because she became the mother of all the living. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thanks be to God. with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, Lord.
The angel Gabriel was sent from God to a town of Galilee called Nazareth, to a virgin betrothed to a man named Joseph of the house of David. And the virgin's name was Mary. And coming to her, he said, "Hail, full of grace, the Lord is with you." But she was greatly troubled at what was said, and pondered what sort of greeting this might be. Then the angel said to her, "Do not be afraid, Mary, for you have found favor with God. Behold, you will conceive in your womb and bear a son, and you shall name him Jesus. And he will be great, and will be called the Son of the Most High. And the Lord God will give him the throne of David, his father, and he will rule over the house of Jacob forever, and of his kingdom there will be no end." But Mary said to the angel, "How can this be, since I have no relations with a man?" And the angel said to her in reply, "The Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. Therefore, the child to be born will be called Holy, the Son of God. And behold, Elizabeth, your relative, has also conceived a son in her old age, and this is the sixth month for her, who was called barren, for nothing will be impossible for God." Mary said, "Behold, I am the handmaid of the Lord. May it be done to me according to your word." Then the angel departed from her. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Yesterday was the anniversary of the death of Father Mulholland. He was pastor here for 24 years. He actually built this church. So, 1953, he, along with the 350 members of the parish at the time, got them together and did what they had to do to raise the funds and so forth. One of the things he made sure to include was beautiful altarpiece that is a hand copy of the original painting that's in Spain. The name of the painting is Immaculate Conception. So if you had to draw a picture or paint a picture of the Immaculate Conception, I can think of almost nothing that surpasses this. What do you see in the picture? The picture is of the woman to whom the archangel said, "Hail, full of grace." Full of grace means immaculate one. So the Immaculate Conception is actually known by another name, Mary. But she was given a new name by the archangel, Immaculate One or Full of Grace. Now when we pray, "Hail, Mary, full of grace," of course we're including both names in the salutation, which is perfectly fine and very traditional. When the Blessed Virgin Mary appeared in the Lourdes, France in 1858 to a 14-year-old peasant girl named Bernadette, Bernadette didn't know who she was, just a beautiful lady in white. And Bernadette kept asking this beautiful lady in why, who are you? Bernadette was smart in the sense that she sprinkled this beautiful lady with holy water. She knew enough about her religion that if it was a demonic thing, then this beautiful lady would fled. But beautiful lady did not flee. So the beautiful lady came to Bernadette February 11, 1858, for the first time, came almost every day for 2 weeks. Who are you? Finally, on March the 25th, which is exactly 9 months before Christmas, which of course commemorates the incarnation of Jesus, of God, the Son of God, I should say, the beautiful lady spoke. Who are you? She said, I am the Immaculate Conception, in Bernadette's native tongue. So Bernadette had been asked by her priest, you get the name of this lady that you're supposedly seeing. And Bernadette went, she kept repeating, Immaculate Conception. Immaculate Conception. Bernadette had no way of knowing that terminology. She wasn't schooled very well. And the Pope had only recently declared it as an infallible teaching in 1854. So when she arrived at the pastor's house in the rectory, she said, I have the name of the lady. What's her name? She said, Immaculate Conception. The pastor almost fell out of his chair because he realized that that Bernadette did see a heavenly visitor. And the heavenly visitor was, in fact, the Mother of God. So the moral of the story is, the Blessed Virgin Mary is real. She continues her ministry today. I'm not saying that we're all going to see her before we die. If we get to heaven, we'll see her. But she has made appearances in this world. The most important thing she ever did was give the world Jesus. Now, her being the Immaculate Conception, or she being the Immaculate Conception, means that she was conceived immaculately in the womb of her mother, St. Anne. Meaning, at her conception, she was brought into the world without any taint of sin. Whereas, because of the fallenness of the human race, when people are conceived in the mother's womb, they're not holy. That's what original sin means. She did not have original sin. Now, it was a miracle, and the reason why she didn't have it was because she was redeemed ahead of time. Why was Mary redeemed ahead of time so she could carry Jesus? Because Jesus, God in the flesh, could not be in any way mixed with sin or unholiness. So, you know, if you've ever gone on a ship that's gone through a canal, like the Panama Canal, or between two bodies of water that can't mix together, there's something called a set of locks that's the waters from coming together. So Mary was something like this set of locks so that God could enter into the world and start the human race all over again. The old Adam and Eve were responsible for bringing down the human race, the fall of man. The new Adam, the new Eve are Jesus and Mary. We work very well together to collaborate in the redemption of the world. So think about this and pray the rosary every day. Ask the Blessed Lady for her assistance. She makes a big difference even today because we need Jesus. We need to live lives of grace. We need to be holy. That's her specialty. The Blessed Mother helps people to be faithful to their baptismal commitments, meaning rejecting sin, rejecting Satan, professing and living the faith, and living holy lives. That is her specialty. Somebody once said, devotion to the Blessed Mother is a sign of election. So I would urge people, pray every day, the rosary. In the Sistine Chapel in the Vatican, There is the famous fresco, and fresco means a painting on plaster, of the Last Judgment. Jesus is in the middle of the painting, people on his right hand are ascending up, people on his left hand are going down to the netherworld. Well, the sight of the people on his right hand are being hoisted up by what looks like a chain, and what the chain really is the rosary. And that's a good reason. Michelangelo wanted to make the point in his painting about how powerful Mary's intercession is. And also, to stand up against non-Catholic people, some of them who very much have a bias against the Blessed Lady. If it weren't for Mary, we'd have no Jesus, and we'd have no hope. We could get into heaven, could rise from the dead. Things would be completely different. So we have to always be thankful for who she is, what she's about, and the hope that she holds out. We say she is our life, our sweetness, and our hope. That is true, because of her son.
Innocent Lamb who would wipe away our offenses and place her above all others. be for of your people an advocate of grace and a model of holiness. And so, in company with the choirs of angels, we praise you, and with joy we proclaim, Holy, holy, holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. In part, indeed, holy, 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 so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me.
Take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Let
Behold, the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but on the same word my soul shall be healed. Glorious things are spoken of you, O Mary, for from you arose the Son of Justice, Christ our God.
Thank you.
sacrament we have received, O Lord our God, heal in us the wounds of that fault, from which in a singular way you preserve the blessed Mary and her immaculate conception through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
I thank you for coming tonight. I know it's a sacrifice with the COVID and everything. Please be safe. Wear the mask and do everything you're supposed to do. After Mass, we'll be sanitizing the church. So just have a nice orderly procession out. Be careful going out of the parking lot. Be safe. Start and so forth. Watch, especially for kids running around or whatever. And again, try to pray every day. Try to pray the rosary. Pray for the country because we really need it. We need to overturn the culture of death. So ask the Blessed Lady. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
The mighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.